So, good afternoon. Today we have the honor to receive Dr. Diego Mesina from Maza University in Argentina, our partner. Dr. Diego, before we start our interview, let me make a few statements, okay? Number one, our interview will be distributed under a Creative Commons license. Number two, the transcription of our interview will be published in Portuguese by the Periódico Che Química and in English by the Southern Journal of Sciences. Number three, our interview is scheduled to last more or less 45 minutes. And number four, very relevant, I am not a reporter, okay?
Okay, agree.
Thank you, Dr. Diego. Dr. Diego, before we start, could you please introduce yourself to the audience?
Okay, good afternoon. I am Diego. I live in Mendoza, Argentina. I'm a nutritionist, a PhD in biological sciences, and master's degree in physical activity and health. And currently, I am the science director in University Maza.
Thank you, Dr. Diego. Thank you very much. And thank you for receiving us today. Okay. Let me start with our questions. Number one, regarding the institution, what is the oldest course offered by the Maza University and when it was founded?
Okay, Maza University was founded in 1960 in Mendoza, Argentina. It was the first private university in all the western region of our country. And it started offering the course of pharmacology and biochemistry, as we know nowadays. This is the career with the largest trajectory in all the Western country.
Perfect. Thank you very much. Currently, which is the most popular course offered by the university? The ones that has most, the students look for the most?
Okay. The most popular courses in our university are mainly two. First, kinesiology, and second, human nutrition. They are very popular in the country because they offer a lot of career opportunities and professional possibilities, and they are evolving permanently and in constant change. But we have a third very popular career that is the unique one in all the Western Argentina, that is veterinary sciences. That is very popular as well.
Perfect. Dr. Diego, let's go to our third question. Which are the research areas with the highest number of scientific publications in Maza University, and in which fields do they stand out?
Okay, the first field of interest in research is veterinary sciences, as I told you. They excel in two great areas that are genetics and parasitology, and they encompass a wide range of animal models such as bees, rabbits, rodents, zebrafish, large animals such as cows and horses, and also domestic animals like dogs and cats. That's why this is the area that with the most publications, with a long trajectory, and they have the only veterinary hospital of large animals. That's why they produce a lot of papers permanently. And we have a second important area of research that are wine industry. And this is constantly growing nowadays, and they are currently studying climatic change and how this affects the wine production and all the sensitive or sensory characteristics of wine, such as color, aroma, and flavor.
Perfect. This is very important because Mendoza is a traditional wine region.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
I can't wait to taste it. It will be amazing. Oh,
you will be amazed.
I hope so.
And your wife too.
Oh, yes, yes. You will meet her. It will be very good.
Okay.
So, let's go to our fourth question. Dr. Diego, how many postgraduate courses, master and doctor, okay, does the University of Maza currently offer and in which areas of knowledge?
Okay, currently, Maza University is offering three master's degrees. One of them is in wine industries management, which is very important for the region. The second one is a master's degree in higher education. This is very popular throughout the country because it has been taught for many years, more than 10 years. And the third one is a master's degree in corporate and institutional communication. But our university also provides different levels of postgraduate courses, such as specializations, we call them in our country, in human resources, in pediatric nutrition, metabolic nutrition, in clinical illnesses and pathologies of small animals, which means pets.
Perfect. Thank you very much. Does the university offer any type of accommodations or a university residence for students? If so, what options are available and how are the facilities and infrastructures to accommodate the students, including foreigners outside from Argentina?
Yes, our university provides a university residence that is located near the campus, very near to the campus, and it can accommodate up to 20 students from different nationalities or residents. And it is also located halfway between the campus of the university and the sport campus of the university, which provides swimming pool, gym, tennis court, gazebos, and a lot of recreational areas. And it's also near the library. So it is very well located in the eastern part of the Mendoza city.
Very good. Our next questions. When international students wish to study in Maza University, what's the process from sending the student's proposal until their arrival in the university?
Okay, the process is really simple. First, the students must choose their career and choose the moment of the year they want to arrive Mendoza, because our year begins in March or April. Then they have to contact with the International Relations Department. Third, they have to sign agreements. And the fourth step is just coming to Mendoza and start studying. This is very plain and simple.
Perfect. This is very good. Mm-hmm. So let's go to our next question. Okay. So, Dr. Diego, the Maza University is participating in the second edition of the Southern Science Conference, which follows a different model of organization involving multiple universities. What benefits does the university expect to bring to its students by engaging in its international projection through this event?
Okay, this event is very relevant to our students, because it will provide opportunities first to expand their minds, expand their horizons, and think in a different way. Second, they can connect with other students and other researchers from throughout the world. And third, we think that this is very relevant because our students and our researchers will find opportunities to publish in different congresses, in different journals, and besides the opportunities to travel abroad and know different cultures and different countries with their research.
This is amazing. Mm-hmm. As a representative of the scientific committee, they are all very welcome in the conference.
And okay,
I hope to meet you all in person.
Yes, you will.
Considering the challenges imposed by the time zone differences, Which suggestions would you give for the organizing committee of the event, aiming to maximizing the participation of students from your university? Let me just make an addendum, okay? This year in Mendoza is perfect schedule because you are the hosting city. But let's suppose in a future edition, it's another, even maybe another continent. What suggestions could be used?
Okay, for this year, we will not have any problems because fortunately, we are the hosting city and we share the same time zone with all Latin American countries, including Brazil, Chile, or just 1 or 2 hours different. So for next editions, we encourage our students and our researchers to get connected, to use Meet or use calendars, not to lose any of the schedules. This is something that we make currently with that we did with the World Cup. We are used to changing time zones, so this will not be a problem.
So, Okay. Continue, Diego. By participating in an international event at no cost to the students, the university demonstrates its commitment to offering valuable opportunities to the students. How do you assess the importance of students' participation in international events for their academic and professional development?
Okay, we strongly encourage our students to participate in this kind of events. We tell them that the future is now, and now is when they have to start planning their futures and how they want it to be. First, we need and we have to tell them that participating in this event or other events gives them the highest chances to get scholarships, not only national scholarships, but also international scholarships, because an international event is very heavy for their CVs. In the second order, they are more likely to get international positions by participating in these international events. So they are very important. And third, we tell them that by participating in this event, they will get an important and they will achieve an international profile. Their minds will change positively. They will expand their horizons and their vision, and it will be very positive for their careers and their academic positions.
Perfect. Dr. Diego, we are getting to our last question, okay? The conference will also organize specific sections for the exchange of experience between librarians, publishers, and editors of the universities, like our own local journals, okay? Do you believe that this experiment could create new institutional communication channels, including joint international publications?
Yes, of course. This is a very interesting question because Maza University has an international journal that is called ICU, which in Spanish means Research, Science, and University. That is a journal that has been growing for more than 8 years. It was founded in 2016. It's a multidisciplinary journal that encompasses a wide range of publications from veterinary, human health, communication, earth, climate, and environment. And by joining this experiment, as you tell them, we can provide a bank of editors and reviewers for other journals of the world. And we can also benefit from the provision of editors and reviewers from other journals. So it's a win-win situation, yes? And that will be a very interesting experiment to meet all of them and to make our journals grow even better.
Thank you. I appreciate your view, and it's very important. I think it's a great step for all academic journals and a very nice way to grow. So,
yes, it is.
Dr. Diego, as final words, okay? First, I would like to apologize for the way that the screen is split. I don't know why this is happening. I will talk to my tech support, so in the future, it will not happen again, okay? And on behalf of the committee of the event, I would like to say thank you very much for receiving us today, for having the time to receive us, to present Maza University, and especially your kindness and your patience with me. Thank you very much, Dr. Diego.
Okay. Thank you all. Thank you for inviting us. Thank you for making this event in our city. And it will be a very large pleasure to receive you. We are so emotional.
Thank you very much. See you in a couple of weeks.
Okay, Luis. It will be a pleasure.
My pleasure. Bye-bye.